Christmas. Screwed up in the end there. Mr. Dolehole, you keep messing me up, jumping around and screaming. Sorry about that, folks. Listen, that's as good as it's gonna get. I'm gonna have to go back and practice some more. That was about 16 takes. But that's not why I'm here. Why I'm here is to talk about true manger stories. Manger stories that are true. So while I go back and practice this song some more, you just sit back and relax and get ready for some true manger stories. We'll be right back.
Drink Diet Mountain Dew, 'cause you're on a diet and you wanna lose weight.
Our first story will take place dealing with the three wise men. What's interesting about this is that the Bible really doesn't say ever that there's three. Luke doesn't even mention them, and Mark, or maybe it's Matthew, I don't really know. They don't give a count. We do know who some of them were, though. There was Balthazar, Gaspar, and Craig. But according to the gospel, according to Seamus, we now know that there were two other wise men. Dr. Zaius and Yoda. It's commonly known that they brought frankincense, myrrh, and gold. Balthazar brought frankincense, Gaspar brought the myrrh, and Craig brought the gold. Dr. Zaius brought a talking little dolly, and Yoda brought the gavelta fish. Happy birthday. Our next story talks about the angel. Everyone likes to put the angel on top of the manger like she was hanging around. She wasn't even there. According to Luke, she appeared to a bunch of shepherds and said, "Don't freak out. There's going to be a baby, and it's totally cool." And then a bunch of other angels came down and sang. I'm not kidding. In Matthew, the angel appeared to Joseph in a dream, also saying, "Don't freak out. You know, your baby's coming. It's not really yours. Whatever." But the gospel, according to Seamus, tells a little bit of a different story. After the angel appeared to the shepherds, she went through the desert to get to see the birth of Jesus. On the way, she came across a wounded hyena. Taking pity on the hyena, she nursed it back to health, and she totally missed the birth. But the hyena ended up showing up later at the manger. That's why in traditional Greek Orthodox and Italian Orthodox mangers, there's always a hyena hanging out with the baby Jesus. Now you know why. Hey, Mr. Dolehole, we're filming. What are you doing down here? We need you for the next segment. Is this about your contract? Because we're not dealing with this contract. No, I'm not giving you more money. No, I'm tired of your crap. Get upstairs. We're in the middle of filming. We are in the middle of filming this. We can't get into your contract bullshit again. Look, we'll go up. No, 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 no. Oh, what the f***? Before the wise men arrived, there was another story that took place. Before the wise men came, and before everyone else came, and the angel didn't come, but the hyena had already arrived. See, the king heard stories of a new king that was going to be born, so he freaked out. And he sent the most dreaded people he could find to capture the young baby Jesus. General Ursus and Captain Phasma. These two were going to take out the manger. Or so they thought.
Well, that about wraps it up for amazing true manger tales. Thanks for joining us, and remember, if you're laying in a manger, it's probably true. Merry Christmas.